Jadi waktu yang diberikan untuk Virgi setiap ya, setiap peserta atau setiap guru ini waktu yang diberikan 20 menit untuk Virgi. Jadi gunakanlah kebaikannya untuk yang backgroundnya itu di apa? Yang ribut sekali, tidak tahu di mana sih yang ribut sekali ada suara. Oke Bu, Ibu Nurin silahkan.
Iya, bisa terlihat layarnya?
Belum sampai saat ini belum saya.
Not yet, ma'am.
Not yet.
Apa itu Ibu Nurin? Siap-siap ya, Ibu Hamzah ya. Atau siapa yang siap setelah Ibu Nurin ini ya?
Saya Bu.
Oh iya, Hamzah.
Okay, ya. Saya Bu.
Setelah Ibu Nurin bisa ya. Oke, Ibu Nurin silakan.
Bisa kelihatan layarnya?
Kalau saya belum, belum bisa.
Oh iya.
Sudah? Lagi ya?
Sudah muncul teman?
Bukan. Iya, Bu.
Alhamdulillah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillah. How's everything today?
Yeah.
We are fine, ma'am.
We are fine.
Alhamdulillah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Don't forget to express our gratitude to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala who bless us a good health today to run all the activities. Okay. Before we start this class, Amri, would you like to lead your friend for praying?
Okay, friends, before we start our lesson today, let's go pray again. Okay, finish.
Thank you, Amri, for helping. Okay, student. Do you still remember that when you were still at grade 7, you have already studied about how to describe parts of the house? Do you remember that? Sulfika, do you still remember when you were still at grade 7, you have already studied about how to describe parts of the house?
Oh, yes, ma'am. I remember.
So today we are also going to describe something, but not about parts of house anymore, but something else. Anyone else? Is there anyone of you get the idea what we are going to learn this morning?
Describing animal,
how do you know that?
I see.
Yes.
We see your brain, ma'am.
Oh yeah.
Good. You are great students. We are going to talk about describing animal. Do you know that why we have to know how to describe something? Do you know why it is very, very important to know how to describe something, especially something around us?
To give information. To give information to someone.
To express your idea, to give information, to make other people understand you. And the last is, and the most important thing is, we have to describe the things well in order to be a successful person in the future. But why we have to do it in English? Any idea?
No.
Maybe some of you say, just say it in Bahasa. Why we have to study how to describe something in English? Huldi, do you know why we have to describe something in English? Like what we are going to do now?
Yeah, to give information to others about something, ma'am. To describe something and then give information to others that the animal or the house look like, for example.
Great answer. Thank you, Huldi.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Why we have to describe it in English? We know that today is a very, very cutting edge era. We have to know the technology and all the technology, all the things related to us related to English. So we have to know how to describe something in English. And at the end, maybe you will be always a great person. A great person also know how to describe something well in English or in Arabic or other as. And now, in this case, we are going to describe the things in English, especially about an animal. Okay, student. Get the point so far?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you. Look at this. This is the learning goals that we are going to get today, and I hope by learning this, by understanding these learning goals, you will be a great person. Okay, all the best for you all, my beloved students. Okay, the learning goals for today is Hafsa, would you like to read the learning goals today?
Yes, mom.
Yeah, thank you for helping.
The learning goals we are going to know what the function, a social function of descriptive text is.
And okay, the second, thank you. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. Thank you, Hafsa. The next, Wahida, yeah, would you like to read the second point? Are you Hidaya? What about Stefanus, please? The second point.
The second point.
Yes.
Okay. We are going to know the generic structure of descriptive text, ma'am.
Okay. Sulfikar, what about the third point? Would you like to help me to read it?
Yes, ma'am. We are going to know the language feature of the descriptive text.
Okay, thank you so much. And the last is Ibrahim, would you like to read the last? Are you here, Ibrahim? Are you still with us?
Ibrahim
is not here, ma'am. Okay. Low connection.
Okay. And what about Mr. Imran? Would you like to read the last? The class is going to create our descriptive text, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, student. You're very kind. Okay, so that's the four point the four points that we are going to learn today: the social function, the generic structure, the language feature, and also how to read very short descriptive text. Okay, now before we watch a video related to what are the things that we are going, would you like to sit with your group one and group two? Make sure that all of your name are there. Is there
Imran, ma'am? Pak Imran
tidak ada namanya. Pak Imran dan namanya Imran.
Oh, Mr. Imran, sorry. Okay, get it? Okay, so sit with your group. After that, we are going to watch a movie that will describe to us what is the social function is, what are the generic structure and language features are, and also how to make a structure of writing in order to make a simple and short descriptive text about animal. So this is the video, and let's watch it. Can you hear the voice? Hi, guys.
No, ma'am. No voice, ma'am.
Okay, we repeat it once again. Hope it will be better.
I can hear, ma'am, but...
Okay, we start.
Hi, kembali lagi di YouTube channel saya. How are you doing all? So in this video, we will learn about descriptive belajar tentang tes deskripsi. So, what is descriptive text? Descriptive text is a text which focuses to describe or to tell one subject. Tes deskripsi adalah sebuah teks yang
fokus pada deskripsi.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
How about the characteristics of descriptive text? Bagaimana karakteristik dari descriptive text? The first point is descriptive text is attribute verb like is, am, are. The second point is this text in the form of simple present tense. Jadi bentuk teks ini adalah dalam bentuk simple present tense. And the third point is descriptive text focus only in one subject. Hanya fokus pada satu subjek saja. Structure of descriptive text. The first is identification. Identification contains general introduction of the person, place, animals, or the object that will be described. Identification ini adalah pendahuluan atau gambaran umum tentang orang, tempat, hewan, atau objek yang akan dideskripsikan. Dan biasanya, identification ini berada di paragraf pertama. Second point is description. This part contains the description of the subject by describing its features, forms, colors, and anything related to the subject. Poin kedua adalah deskripsi atau ciri-ciri khusus objek tersebut. Jadi di bagian ini akan digambarkan segala hal secara spesifik tentang objek tersebut seperti bentuknya, rupanya, warnanya, dan segala hal yang terkait dengan objek yang dideskripsikan tersebut. Well, now let's take a look at the following descriptive text. Sekarang mari kita perhatikan bersama-sama teks deskripsi berikut. Monkeys are clever mammals that solve problems.
Okay, student. That's about the this about the description about what are social functions, the general structure, and also the language feature of the text. Any question about what is the three items that we are going to learn today? Well, Hidayat, would you like to restate again what is the social function of the descriptive text?
Yes, madam. Social function of the descriptive text is give information about something.
Yeah. Describe or tell about one thing.
Okay, good.
Okay, and the characteristic of the descriptive text is uses with the attribute is or are. Okay, position on one subject. And what else? This is the structure of descriptive text. There are two structures of the descriptive text: identification and description. Okay, student, do you get the point?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. So, look at in your group, please
read this text and then find out the what is the social function of the text, what is the structure of the text, and at least write down two language features of the text in your group. Okay. Any question about this first activity?
No, man.
I give you 10 minutes to do this. Yeah. Don't be afraid to tell to Alice to ask something to me if you have a problem about this. Okay, time is up. So then we move to the activity two. Now let's go out to the class and then observe what group one and group two, please go out to the class and find out what animal you can find around our school. Let's go out.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, finish. Yeah, group one. Group one. This. Amri, what animal you find out from our environment, our school environment, with your group?
We find
and
fly. Yes.
What else? What else?
Flies.
And any more?
Bird. We find a lot of animals, man.
Okay, choose one with your group, because the next after this we are going to describe it by we are going to describe the animal by naming the animal name, the habitat, the food, the activity, and the characteristic. The characteristic here could be about the color, about the state of the animal, physical character, or maybe the behavior of the animal. In a very simple text like this example. Okay, so please choose one of your animal. What is the animal is chosen by your group?
We choose bird, man.
Bird. Okay. Group two. Erawati, are you with me, Erawati?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Erawati. Have you observed something out from our school environment? What animal did you find with your group?
We found a goat.
Good. Okay. Any more? Any other animal?
Horse.
Yeah, horse. So, which animal? Which animal will be chosen by your group? From both of them.
So, we choose goat, ma'am.
Good. Say again.
Yeah.
Good. Okay. Good. So, group one will describe about birds, and then group two is going to describe about good. Okay. We are going to move to the last step of our study today, of our meeting today. The last is making a simple short descriptive text like this. Yeah, like this. By you have already choose the name of animal. Okay, now you choose the habitat. It could be like this. The habitat is live in northern part of the world, or maybe you can say live in the grassland or any other.
Okay, and then you choose the food, take the animal. The animal, it could be the physical characters, or maybe, or it could be this the behavior of the animals. Any other else that can describe, that can make the animal clear by the reader. Okay, any questions so far before we make a short descriptive text in group? Okay, no one. Okay, thank you. So I hope that you can create your sentence easily after after taking information about all these items. Okay, so you can start it. You can start your writing now. Please fill the slot here first to make your writing easy. Easier to make your writing easier. And do you find any difficulty to this to mention all the this the items here?
Group one.
Yeah. Okay. Just post it in WA group because we have not a good connection. Okay. What about group two? Ibrahim, what about your group? Is it finished already?
Finished, ma'am.
Ibrahim, do you still here with us? Okay, thank you. So, also, I think that's enough for today, students. Before we finish this class, let make sure that you have already submitted all the tasks, activity one and activity two in our WA group, and also okay. Before we stop this, before we finish this class, is there any one of you wanna express about your feeling after having our class today? What are the things that you have learned? Anyone wanna be volunteer?
I will clearly.
What we have learned today? Karen, would you like to express, to describe your feeling to your friend?
Yeah. I feel
time is yours.
I feel our learning today is so attractive and it's so clear that what we get about the description text and how to describe the animal.
Any more? Yes. Okay. Any else?
Me, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes, please.
Yeah, I'm happy to be here, ma'am, in your class.
Because I'm so happy also.
Yes, because I know more about animals and also how to describe animals.
Any more? No more, Huldi?
No more, ma'am, but I'm really happy to be with you, ma'am, here.
Okay, I'm really happy too. So have a great time and hope you be a great person in the future.
You too,
okay, because all of you, all of you are the leaders in the future. Okay, be sure. And we always pray for all the best for you all. Okay, thank you. I think that's all. And don't forget next meeting. Next meeting, we are going to explain about how to describe our activity. So thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, thank you, Ibu Nuraini.
Yeah.
Ibu Nuraini mengajar kelas berapa ya?
Kelas 8, Bu, grade 8.
Grade 8. Oh, kelas 8 ada descriptive text kah? Untuk
ada, Bu.
Maksudnya di ini silabus pandemi atau silabus yang biasa?
Silabus yang biasa,
Bu. Artinya regular ya.
Yeah.
Oh, ada ya.
Iya, yeah. Any else zookeeper? My uncle is zookeeper.
Oh, I see. Ya, saya tahunya saya tidak pernah mengajar kelas 7 ya. Lain yeah. Pernah yang tahun kemarin DTG 2019 yang luring ya. Ada yang menyajikan tentang descriptive text kelas 7 di semester genap.
Iya. Yeah. Ada juga
ya. Menurut ini oh di kelas 8 di semester berapa ya? Semester.
Bab 7 semester.
Semester yeah. Ganjil ya.
Iya.
Yeah. Persiapannya nanti Ibu Nuraini inilah yang akan ditampilkan di UKIN nanti.
Iya. Yeah. Bukan. Kalau bisa Mem, kalau bisa boleh.
Artinya begini kan sebelumnya Mem sudah diancang-ancang disuruh buat 3 SOP dengan materi ajarnya ya. Di persiapan itu ada semester ganjil dan semester genap supaya tiba-tiba begitu ada UKIN yang diminta sudah artinya Anda semua sudah standby ya. Itu harapannya okay, kan semua yang diumpar begitu. Iya, oke, okay, thank you. Jadi saya kira itu teks deskriptif hanya di kelas 7. Oh, ternyata di kelas 8 ada ya di semester yeah. Ganjil ya. Oke. Okay. Tapi tadi ya, seandainya Ibu Nur ini yang ini nanti ditampilkan di UKIN, ada tadi mungkin salah ucap atau gimana ya. Generic structure descriptive text itu ada dua. Ya, ada dua itu. Yang pertama, yang satu apa? Apa yang pertama?
Identification.
Yes, identification dengan description, hanya dua.
Description.
Hanya dua yang saya. Jadi seandainya itu yang nanti ditampilkan di UKIN, please belajar dengan baik. Pokoknya Anda semua hebat deh. Tapi kan namanya juga kadang-kadang kita grogi karena yang kita hadapi ini teman-teman. Tapi saya yakin kalau di UKIN itu nanti betul-betul real teaching, ya.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sudah full English ini. Thank you, hebat kalian. Karena yang nanti menilai itu buka dua orang, satu bukan dosennya umpar yang menilai biasanya. Dosen dari luar yang partnernya umpar yang tahun kemarin itu yang saya temani partner dosen dari Makassar, dosen dari Makassar seperti dari UI Universitas Muhammadiyah Makassar, ada juga dari tadi yang saya sama pasangnya dari Makassar aja, bukan dari umpar. Saya temani pasangan untuk uji kinerja nanti. Jadi kalau yang Anda semua yang menampilkan tentang this text, apakah itu procedure text, tolong dong dihafal betul-betul, itu dikuasai betul tentang generic structure setiap text. Karena utamanya ini deskriptif. Kenapa? Deskriptif text itu ada pembandingnya, yaitu text apa yang di kelas 9, report text. Beda sedikit itu. Kalau report text generic structure-nya yaitu yang kalau di descriptive identification, report adalah general classification, kemudian description semuanya, ya itu aja. Itu saya aja masukan saya supaya Anda betul-betul hebat semua. Kenapa? Karena dari sini, dari peer teaching, ada bayangan, oh yang ini bisa, hebat ini semua. Untuk semuanya saya sudah bisa melihat Anda semua mengajar, ya sudah mas, ya ini ya. Hebat-hebat kalian,